Hey kids, it's Mr. Ollie from the Farmington STEAM Academy ICenter. I hope you're doing well. I heard it's your 50th day of school, so I thought, let's take a trip back in time. The decade of hula hoops and Elvis Presley, poodle skirts and James Dean, soda fountains and drive-in theaters. So let's all hop in my time machine and go back to 1950, 70 years ago. Here's some fast facts for you. That's better. So it's 1950. You're going to school. You're hanging out with friends. What kind of things are cool back then? How much do things cost? Let me tell you. Minimum wage in 1950 was 75 cents an hour. If you wanted to fill up your car, a gallon of gas would cost 18 cents. If you needed to mail a letter to somebody, a stamp would cost you a whole 3 cents. The total population in 1950 in the United States was just over 150 million people. Sounds like a lot, but 70 years later, we've more than doubled that. The most popular toys in the United States in 1950? Silly Putty, Wooly Willy, Magic 8 Ball, and Little People. In 1950, the New York Yankees won the World Series. The Cleveland Browns were your NFL champion. The Minneapolis Lakers, not in LA yet, they won the NBA title. And finally, your Stanley Cup champions, Detroit Red Wings. 70 years ago, James Dean made his first appearance in a television commercial for Pepsi.
Pepsi Cola hits the spot, a big, big bottle, and it's got bounce, 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 bounce. Go get Pepsi for the Pepsi.
Minute Rice first appeared on shelves in stores. Before that, it was like 10-minute rice. In 1950, thankfully, disposable diapers were invented. What did they do with diapers before that? You don't want to know. The first metal lunchbox was created, and it starred Hopalong Cassidy.
Hopalong Cassidy, that's who.
The cereal Corn Pops debuted in 1950. The name changed twice in 1951 to Sugar Corn Pops, then just Sugar Pops. In 1978, it changed back to Sugar Corn Pops, then finally back to original Corn Pops in 1984. In 2006, it became Pops, and then back to Corn Pops a few months later. Did you follow that? Earl Lloyd became the first African-American NBA basketball player. You guys may have seen Smokey the Bear before. He's a mascot, preventing forest fires. Well, in 1950, Smokey the Bear was a real bear. He was rescued from a forest fire and later became a living mascot for wildfire prevention. On February 15th of 1950, Disney released Cinderella. Some popular children's books were written in 1950, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by C.S. Lewis. And also Dr. Seuss released If I Ran the Zoo. It was the first book to contain the word nerd. The FBI started the top 10 most wanted list in 1950. There was a movie that came out called Treasure Island, released by Disney. Until then, nobody knew how pirates talked. But thanks to Disney and Treasure Island, we now know that they talked like this. Arr! You know the musical Hamilton? Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Well, in 1950, the big musical was Guys and Dolls. It debuted in 1950 on stage and ran until 1953. They later made a movie starring Frank Sinatra. So there you have it. Some fast facts about the year of 1950, 70 years ago. Hard to believe. Happy 50th day of school. I hope you're celebrating. I hope you're dressing up like you're in the 50s still, even if you're at home. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.
The prison band was there, they began to wait. The band was jumping and the drum began to swing. You should have heard the locked out jailbird sing that rock.